Now, how nice would it be for the second you finish editing a photo and you hit that save button, that is on your phone seconds later, ready to post on Instagram? And I mean instantly. I mean, the second you hit save, export, whatever, it's on your phones, ready to post. Sound good? Let's jump in. Anyone else just have like a bottle of hot sauce just lying on their desk? I find myself just chugging hot sauce literally all the time. Tasty. What's happening, YouTube? My name's Paul, a travel and landscape photographer currently based in Melbourne. In today's video, what we're going to be talking about is getting your photos from your computer to your phone, ready to post on Instagram as fast as possible. This editing workflow, it's mainly because I'm using a Windows computer and I have an iPhone. There's no easy way to transfer one between the other. It's kind of lots of little steps in between. So this is why I've kind of came up with this little solution to it. If you have a Mac and an iPhone, you can just use AirDrop. Super simple, clean. But if I'm being honest, I think this is a slightly better way, even if you are on all Apple devices. Now, if that sounds good to you, I want you to stick around to the end of the video. But first, I want to do a little bit of a life update for the longtime followers. Now, if you're not interested in my little life update, please jump to this part of the video and we'll commence there. Guys, welcome back to 2021. This is my first video of the year, a little later than I wanted to, but work's been a little bit crazy. We'll get into that in a second. So not only is this the first video back in 2021, this is the first one back since my little creative hiatus. For those that have been following, you might have noticed a little bit of a drop off after last year. Being trapped inside for that long and not being able to meet new people, take new photos, go on adventures, kind of plays a lot with my energy. Like I need to be out creating new content, taking new photos. That's kind of what keeps me going. But anyway, towards the end of the second lockdown, I went a little bit stir crazy, getting a little bit sick of social media, and I took a little bit of a break, a 2-month break in fact. The lockdown ended, we're allowed to go out, work started to pile back up, Christmas hit, just finishing the back date of work now. Yeah, I think I finished my last video that I have at the moment this morning. Madness. Like, there's been so much going on, it's ridiculous. So, first things first, we moved house, we have a new space. My girlfriend bought a house and I lucked out and got this brand new studio. It's so nice not being wedged in between the living room, kitchen and bedroom. Boys, got a little bit more space and a little bit more peace and quiet. Along with all that, I'm also in this little limbo stage with my visa. The idea was actually meant to be leaving Australia and going traveling with my girlfriend, and I was actually meant to leave Australia in November there. With nowhere safe to go, I decided to stay here. So I've applied for this activity visa, which would give me another year, but because of Homeland Affairs and all visa people are a little bit behind, I'm kind of in this limbo stage where I could be kicked out at any point, or I could be accepted for 12 months more. It's a little bit draining being in that space of like not knowing if I'm gonna be kicked out or not. So yeah. So now all that serious stuff's out of the way, and like visas and moving and creative hiatus, that's all out of the way. A couple of other fun updates. So we've upgraded the camera and lens combo that we've been using to make these videos after the last couple of years. So instead of the A6500 and the Sigma 18-35, we are now shooting on the Sony A7S III and the Sigma 24-70. Yeah, so we've upgraded the system, a little bit more production value. You know, we're stepping things up here. That's what we're doing. The very sad thing is that the A6500, which I built my entire career off of and portfolio, I had to sadly sell that to kind of compensate for some of my losses. But yeah, I sold that this morning, which was a little bit more emotional than I thought it would be. I don't know. So many memories, so much content, so much built off that one little camera. But I'm glad to see it's got a new home. We've also got a brand new space, which I'm super excited about. Still experimenting with different setups and how I actually want it all to look. Taking my time with this. For those who are interested, I'll be doing like a full office fit out where you can see everything I've got set up in here. Once I got like a new desk, some pictures hung on the wall. Yeah, lots to do. But I guess the other thing is like what I've been doing with all this time, I've been spending a little bit more time just capturing like the day to day and like the little moments between me and my girlfriend. Normally I just snap away on my phone, which is good, but it's only ever normally photos. Try to do a little bit more vlogging and just notes to myself, like on a proper video camera so I can actually save it for years to come. For those of you who stuck around and kind of listened to a little bit of a life update, I really appreciate it. Thank you. So now that we're all caught up, we can probably jump into today's video. It's getting your photos from your editing program to your phone to post to Instagram as fast as possible. This is going to take you a couple of minutes to set up, and it's going to save you so much time in the future. We're going to go over all the pros and cons at the end of this, but basically it's all good. Now, for a lot of people, you might be on all Apple products and use AirDrop, which is super simple and clean. If you're like me and you're not on all Apple products, when trying to get your photos from your editing program to your phone, there's a lot of steps in between. Export it to a certain folder, go to our browser, drive, whatever you use, and then go find it on our phone via the app. So you're probably like, Paul, just hurry up, tell me how we do this. And that is basically utilizing Google Drive to our advantage. For the tech savvy people out there, that's probably super simple. You can just go ahead and do it yourselves, but it's basically using Google Drive or Dropbox, whatever you prefer using, and installing that onto your computer and then having the app on your phone. So for the non-tech savvy people who need a little help installing this and setting this up, that's what we're gonna do right now. First things first, what we're gonna do is we're gonna create a folder inside our pictures or wherever we like to export our photos to, and we're gonna call that Instagram. The second step is have a Gmail account. I think everyone in the free world now has a Gmail account, so if you don't, sign up to one and we'll carry on from here. So the next thing you would want to do is go to your browser, go to Google, and then type in Google Drive download. You're going to navigate to the first link, and then you're going to be presented with two options: download as an individual or team. We're going to go for individuals for this purpose only. So we run the installer, you're going to navigate and then sync that one folder called Instagram. And this is the key part here. This is the key part. Because Google only gives you so much storage for storing things online, like your Gmail account and everything with that, we only want to sync the one folder that we made earlier on. Hit OK. The final step would be downloading the Google Drive app on your phone and then logging in with the same account you have there. And that is it. Once you've downloaded that app and logged in, you're done. So for the purposes of the non-tech savvy people, we're going to run you through a little scenario on how to use this, just so we're all on the same page. We're gonna go jump into Lightroom and export an image, could be Photoshop, whatever you like to use. And we're gonna save that photo into the folder that we made. Now for me, I've got a bunch of different folders because I've already got the system made up, but we're gonna save it into our Instagram folder. So now we're gonna jump into the phone. So we're just gonna open up the Google Drive app. At the top, you're gonna be presented with two options. You should have My Drive and Computer. We're gonna go to Computer, My Laptop, and then there's our folder. We're going to go to Instagram, and then your photo should be there. So you're going to hit the three little dots, and then you're going to hit send a copy, and then save image. And that's it. Now it's ready to post to Instagram or whatever social media platform you use. Simple as that. I want to jump into the pros and cons as why this is good, why this is bad, and you can decide if it's right for yourself. Is this is going to make your workflow super simple. So the second reason this is good is a lot of us don't have color calibrated monitors, so our photos can look completely different from what they do on our laptop to what they look like on our phone. This is a good way because you can flick between the two, and then you can really start to dial in how your photos look between the two devices. The third option is a little bit bonus for me, is that I save two copies out of everything. So a high res and a low res to the exact same folder. And that means kind of wherever I go, I've got this little portfolio of high res images I can flick to anyone or just have on my person. It actually comes in handy a lot more than you'd think. The final point I can think about at the moment, this doesn't just have to be with photos that you're editing. This can be documents, this can be videos. Now the cons kind of feed into this because there's literally one. You're only given so much space with your Google Drive account. I think it might be like 15 gigabytes you can have on online storage. Now it's something to watch out for because you might already have tons of emails that could be clogging up your space. But typically it's not an issue because the time you export your files for Instagram, they're kilobytes, they're toy. So it could take quite a while to fill up. Yeah, that's it guys. That is basically how you get your photos from your editing program to your phone super quick. You wanna see the strangest looking thing? These are my new blue light specs. What do you think? My friends are gonna rip me so hard that I generally couldn't care. It really does help me like sleep better at night, not being surrounded by blue light all day long. But yeah, thank you very much for tuning in this week, guys. I really appreciate it. If you implemented this system and it actually works for you, or if it doesn't work for you, please let me know down in the comments. Always looking for feedback. If you got some value from this video, please consider liking, subscribing, commenting, doing all those YouTube things. But until next time, guys. Peace.